Hi, welcome to Picture This. I'm Chender at Ruth Bach Library, and
I'm Danae from the Village and King Moon Library.
Okay, thank you for joining us for our second of the month conversation sharing great books of a picture books collection every Wednesday of every month. Danae, what do you have to share in this section?
Okay, so I'm going to start with my first two books. And my first book is Let's Play Monsters by Lucy Cousins. And it's another great book from many of the books that she has written. And this story is about a young boy named Gabriel who loves to get chased by monsters. So in this story, you'll see all of his family members, just regular family members, but then he asks them to play and he asks them to change into monsters. So he'll go and you'll be the monster who is green and scary with sharp pointy teeth and feet that are hairy. And so his family member turns into a monster and chases him, but then they can't catch him. So throughout the book, you'll see different family members trying to chase them who turned into monsters. Ooh. And since this is green, you can't see the background of them. But then this one, so, and even their cat turns into a monster. So at that end, we will see, because I think there is one family member that can actually catch him. So you have to find out and read this one to see who can catch Gabriel. And it's a really fun story. My next book is a beginning reader book that we have many, many wonderful books in our collection, and this is the Fly Eye and Fly Girl collection, which is by written by Ted Arnold. So this is a very popular book, and the story is about where Fly Guy and Fly Girl, they're at the zoo, and they end up going into, where is the page? The Creatures of the Night exhibit. And in this story, you'll get to see what kind of creatures are in there. And the type of creatures are fly-eating animals. So you have to find out, will Fly Guy and Fly Girl make it out of this exhibit? Because it looks pretty scary, but not too scary. So I think you'll enjoy it. So this is my second book. And what about you, Chenda?
Well, I have also a series in the beginning reader section. And if you go to the library, you'll see these books that we have the pink labels on. That's the author's last name. And it has like some branches have number one and two. This is the second level, which is for beginning independent readers. And it has more text, but it's just one story. And this series by David A. Adler is about Mo, this boy who has so much energy, and he's trying at all these different sports. So he tries swimming, he tries baseball, he tries basketball, he tries soccer, and he tries football. And every time he's trying a new sport, he always has to persevere and just hang in there, because it's always a challenge to try something new. But he always have adults and other people encouraging to do his best at the sports that he tried. So it's a really great, wonderful beginning reader book series to try. And then I have another series. Oh no, this is a one book. It's a nonfiction, which means we have the subject call number right here. It's called Who Am I by Tim Flatch. It's a peek through pages book of endangered animals. So if you think of endangered animals, what do you see? There's like little clues throughout the book. See, there's a cutout and there's the picture clues right here. And then there's some writing. And then you have to figure out who they're talking about. Like this one, who do you think they're talking about? But this one I'm gonna read. I'm a priceless living work of art with my patterned black and gold shell. I'm known for being a bit slow. So when a predator comes my way, I tuck my head and limbs inside my shell to stay safe. Who am I? Open it. Oh, I'm a plowshare tortoise. Look at his shell. Also, He's very slow. He tucked his head in. And there's other animals that you'll have to figure out throughout the book that are endangered and see if you can guess them with the clue. And at the end of the book, there's more information in the back. But if I show it to you, then you know all of the animals. So that would not be fun. If you like this type of animal, this book, there's an old series that we have in the library. It's called Looking Closely Around. And it look, this one is around the pond, but there's one looking closely around the rainforest, the forest, the garden, the desert. And this one is similar. It doesn't have the peekaboo cut out, but it has part of the animal that you're looking very closely at. Looking closely, what do you see? Swirl of paint, a snowy day? What could it be? And I'll let you see the first one. It's a mallard duck. Look at that. It has more text and so more information maybe for an older reader. But it's a good series to check out if you like this one. All right. And what do you have next? Danaya?
Okay, so I'm going to write on your turtle. And I have a book called Turtle Walk by Matt Phelan. And it's about a turtle family. They are going on a trip. And the trip, that means that, well, since they can't drive, they're going to have to walk. And it starts off with them.
Oh.
It starts off with the season, which is spring. So throughout this book, you're going to start seeing how the seasons start to change. And I mean, there's not a lot of words, so it's very for the young readers, but I thought it was really fun because even with turtle families, you get like the young baby turtles asking, are we there yet? So, you know, it says turtle walk, nice and slow, here we go. So you're starting to see how it's summer, and then eventually it turns to fall, and then at the end, it goes to winter. So you're kind of seeing them walking and walking and walking, and it goes, here we go, are we there yet? And then the parent turtles go, yes. And then you're gonna have to keep reading to find out why they walk so far and so long to get somewhere. And it's a very sweet book, and I thought it was very cute. And you can actually, there's a lot of stuff happening in here, so it's a lot of great things to talk about with your little one, and to even talk about the seasons. And also, if you get Chenda's book and this book, it will be really great to put together. Okay, so my next book is Sweet Child of Mine by Guns N' Roses. So we have many books in our collection that we, many songs that turned into book. So this is one of them, and look at the illustrations. So reading the book, after I finished reading the book, I had to listen to the song. So you have the option of either reading it or singing it while you're looking through the book. And as I was reading, it's always fun to read the excerpts on the side, or if you can see on the side of the book. And it talks about how the band gives new meaning to the unforgettable lyrics as we follow a child's wondrous discovery that music is everywhere around us. And it is. So you'll see it throughout the book, and you get to see all the wonderful illustrations and what they get to do. That is my other book. I have two more left, but Chenda, what about you? You have anything else?
Well, this is similar to Turtle Walk, because this child is thinking about seasons changing and what comes with each season. So this book is titled If Winter Comes, Tell It I'm Not Here by Simona Sarraolo. So it has picture book, the end paper has ice cream, which is summer. And there's sandals, and there's ducks and beach ball. And this little boy here, he loves summer, everything summer, which is swimming and being by the pool and eating ice cream. But then his sister says summer is going to end soon. What happens when the summer ends? He asks. Well, first comes fall, and then the days get shorter. There's a chill in the air, and the trees lose all their leaves. That's what's happening now, isn't it? And then you don't even get to use your swimsuit anymore. and she's scaring him. And there's a page right there. It's a funny page. His mommy is saying, calm down. His sister, his dad is mad at his sister for teasing him. And then his cat just ignore him. And he's, there's nothing to do except to wait. So he waits and it does come true. Winter is coming, so fall, the days get shorter and the trees begin to lose their leaves. But guess what? Look, in the winter, because it's darker sooner, so they get to have movie night, and then it's raining a lot. So, oh, we rarely get to have enough rain to wear our rain boots, and he gets to carry an umbrella. It's so much fun to get all wet. And he doesn't go to the ice cream shop, but he gets to go to a cafe and have hot cocoa. And he's lucky too to live in some place where it snows. And he gets to do all the fun winter things. So even though all the color has been taken out of the world, I would never call it dull. And there's some beautiful colors in winter too. You just have to look for it. So there he is, and he's enjoying the season, and then something comes up in the end. So that's a really wonderful book if you're thinking about the seasons to share. And then I have a series of books. It's an older one. It's by Mark Burnett and illustrated by Klassen. He is a really wonderful illustrator and author team. They started out with these three shapes. If you look at the spine, it's in the picture book under Barnett, square, circle, and triangle. And they are all their own character. So if you know some, after you read these books, see if you can find someone in your life or you know who you can identify as the type of shape that they are. Like triangle, he always likes to break the rules and he is very, very naughty. And there he is. And he plays, in this book, he plays a trick on Square, but Square got back at him because he's afraid of the dark. And then there's Circle. And Circle, everybody thinks Circle is perfect because Circle just seemed to roll around. And Circle loves to follow rules and stick with the rules. And then there's Square. Square also likes to follow the rules, but Square gets really anxious. It's very creative. And sometimes she's so he's so worried. You have to read all three and see if you can find someone in your life or know someone in your life that you can identify with the shapes. Now I show you three shapes so far: square, circle, and triangle. If you close your eyes, imagine what the author, what shape the author is writing about next. What do you think? Let me know, or else we'll have to wait until Mark Burnett decides what square, what shape he's doing next, right? Danaya, what do you have?
So for my last two, I have Brown, The Many Shades of Love, written by Nancy Johnson James and Constance Moore. This is a beautiful book about a young boy who describes the many beautiful hues of his family. I love the words that they use to describe their family. For example, my daddy's brown is an autumn leaf or like a field of wheat. One, and then his sister is sister's brown like polished pine, fragrant, tall, and strong. So I love the words that they use to describe. And it was like my senses for some, when I close my eyes and I'd imagine, and it would help me visualize and to even feel or and to even taste, because my cousins are just babies, all smiles and curly hair. Two are like brown sugar. Brown sugar, doesn't that taste sweet? And then just the color of it. So yeah, I really enjoy this. And I was really amazed with the words that they used, and it's just really wonderful to see the many different colors of different shades of brown. Okay, and then my last one is The Forgotten Crayon by Yoko Maruyama. This is a very sweet story about, if you look at the front cover, there's a boy and a girl, and there's a box of crayons. And if you look at it, the white crayon is the tallest one out of all of the colors. So in the beginning, the box belonged to the boy who would color and use all the colors to draw and to make all of his creations. But as time went on, the white crayon started to notice that everybody was getting shorter, except for the white crayon. And the white crayon was kind of sad. So the day came when the boy didn't want his box of crayons anymore. And he decided to sell them at a yard sale. And the white crayon is very sad. And some of them are sad because they know that they're not going to be around anymore. So one day at a yard sale, a little girl ends up finding her box of crayons. And she's so happy because she was looking for a white crayon. And with a white crayon, she made the most beautiful drawings. So everybody got to have a chance to be used, I guess. And this is a great book about showing you how much participation, how everybody wants to participate and they enjoy it. And also to let you know that sometimes maybe one person might not want everything or something and another person might need it. So it's a really great book. And those are my books. And Chenda, do you have any special books for us today?
I do, but I love your forgotten crayons. I can think of a project where you use the white one to make shapes, and then you have a watercolor that you paint over. So all of those positive white crayon spaces that you use will show up, and then the background will be the watercolor. So really good project too. And it reminds me of the day the crayons quit. Nothing came home.
I should have made a little example too, but next time maybe I'll.
I got two holidays to celebrate and share with you. The first one is February 12th, which is the Lunar Chinese New Year. So there you go. If you celebrate Lunar New Year, you know, usually they make a big celebration, lion dance and everything in Chinatown. And most like San Francisco, we have one in LA and other area, but we can also celebrate at home. This Next New Year by Janet S. Wong, illustrated by Young Suk Choi. And it's just a beautiful telling of how, you know, when you move into a community and you celebrate and you can celebrate the new year that you know. So instead of January 1st, the Lunar Year, New Year is celebrated different days throughout each year. This year is the Year of the Ox, February 12th. And this character in the book, he is half Korean. So even though they call it New Year, his mother makes deokguk. It's a Korean New Year soup. And then he has the community in where he lives. He has his best friend, Glenn, who is French and German. And then they celebrate Chinese New Year with him by ordering Thai food to go. And then his other friend, who's part Hopi and part Mexican, they celebrate Chinese New Year with their neighbor, who is from Singapore. And she gives them these red envelopes stuffed with money.
How funny.
If you want to, you can always stuff it with chocolate. Coins too, but the kids usually love money or dollar coins. And some people I know usually also give $2 bills because they are harder to find.
Oh, I haven't seen a $2 bill in forever.
So they always know it's going to be good, but before the new year comes, they have to sweep out last year's dust and then clean up their whole house from top to bottom. And besides cleaning your house and everything inside, you also have to clean yourself. And tonight they're washing your hair because you want to get rid of all the old dirt and everything. And you even cut your nails and brush your teeth. And then you put on your best outfit that you have. It's nice if you have new clothes for the new year, but you don't have to. It could be just the best clothes that you have. And then you can have firecrackers, but the best thing is on the day of New Year's Day, you will not say one awful thing none of that can't do, not don't have a why me, because this is a fresh start and a second chance to dream big and think of the possibilities to make your dream come true. That's really cool for, so I hope you guys know someone who's giving out the red envelope.
Never know what you're gonna get.
No. And then I have two Valentine's Day book to share. The first one is The Day It Rained Hearts by Felicia Bond. And it's about this little girl, Cornelia Augusta. Isn't that a wonderful name? Cornelia Augusta. It rained hearts. Oh, where is she living? And she used her raincoat pocket to catch as many as she can. It must be getting close to Valentine's Day, she thought. And she set to work making Valentines. The hearts she caught would make perfect cards. So she thought hard, and she'd think of all the friends who, what type of gifts or card that they would like to have. And she made one that looks like this. Who do you think will get a card that has a little pom-pom or tail? And then she made a heart that has holes cut out.
Oh, that looks like cheese.
And then she also made a artistic one that just had drawings and rainbow. Really wonderful. So she made that, and then she mailed it out to her four friends. So if you have a friend that lives far away, maybe you can get a stamp and put it out in the mail. And then, or else, you know, since we're all at home right now, you can always just drop them off at your friend's house, you know, put it in the mailbox. Wouldn't they be surprised if you give them, deliver a Valentine's card? So there's her friends. They all got their personalized card, and it's a really wonderful day because she's thinking of what's she going to make next year. A really wonderful book to celebrate Valentine's Day. And then this one is The Ballad of Valentine by Allison Jackson, illustrated by Trisha Tulsa. I love this book because you can be sent to Oh My Darling Clementine. And it's right here. It's the boy, this lady right here, the girl. And over the hill and over under in the valley over the hill lives her boyfriend who's trying to send her a Valentine. So he's going to sing. In a cabin, in a canyon, near a mountain laced with pine, lived a girl who was my sweetheart, and her name was Valentine. Danaya?
Oh, my darling, oh, my darling, oh, my darling Valentine.
I have written 40 letters, but you've never read a line. Oh, because he gave the letter to a mailman to deliver rain or shine, but he couldn't find their address. So he has to keep on trying to send a letter to her, our message to his Valentine. So he tried it with the homing pigeon. He tried it with the smoke signal. He tried it with everything. Oh, he even tried it with using Morse code with a big rented railroad track. He sent a big Valentine. And the last one he bought an airplane, wrote a message with a big heart underline. But the wind erased three letters, and you're now my and I. Oh,
that's my favorite part.
So he keep on trying, but look at her. She baked a pie. She walked up that high hill, down that valley. And you think she's going to deliver her Valentine? You have to find out. The Ballad of Valentine. And just a reminder that February 13th is a Saturday. The library will be closed, so be sure to order these books before that day if you're interested in them. And if you're interested in any of the books we mentioned today, type in Picture This 0221 in the search bar, and the list of books will appear. And we just thank you for joining us for Picture This. We hope to see you next month on the second Wednesday. Thank you. Stay safe and stay healthy. Bye.
Bye.